All right, man. So first of all, I want to thank you for, you know, partaking in my little C-stand-up thing, man. I'm building my brand, putting on comics that I know, killing it across the nation. Of course, I'm going to put you in the mix. You know what I mean? One of my favorite dudes to work with, man.
I appreciate that. Likewise, I appreciate that.
Yeah, man. So let's go on, jump into this thing, man. Again, give my people a little brief of who you are, where you come from, what you're talking about.
My name is Lawrence Owens. I'm from Landover, Maryland. Started comedy in July of 2003. I met Evan Foster in 2005.
Right.
Like brothers ever since.
Hell yeah. That's cold, man. I love it. I love it, bro. So, you know, like you and I have a lot of conversations about, man, dudes that really, if you look at Netflix's little library, they shit is very weak. And you one of the dudes who I know, if there's a platform out there that's looking for content that wants to outdo them, you got to be a part of that mix, man. If they not giving you a contract within the next 48 well, I won't say 48 hours, that's short, but the next the next 24 months, man, then they really ain't doing what they supposed to be doing, which is trying to create, you know, content that the people like, not just that what the CEOs like or whatever, man. Right. So I love that you on this, bro. I think you're one of the heavy hitters across this country, and dudes don't want to fuck with you or follow you. So check this out, man. This thing I'm primarily centering it around right now, the COVID situation, man. So give me a couple of the events that you were, or the stuff you was working on prior to this thing jumping off, because it came from nowhere. Nobody knew it was about to happen on our level, maybe the government or something, but we were all putting together different things. What were you doing before this shit hit?
Well, what I was doing was I was working on a whole new set to film and then send off to Netflix and other various avenues. Like, I got a couple people who finally was like, I want to work with you. So what I was doing was putting a whole new hour set together. And when you brought me out to Evanston, Illinois, that was, you know, one of the places where I was able to work on that, you know what I'm saying, as far as that. And I was lucky enough and blessed enough to be booked at so many spots to be able to work on that in front of live audiences every night. So that's what I was working on. I was working on a whole new hour to put out there so I could start shopping it around.
Yeah, and man, I know that you're kind of a road warrior, man. I look up and you'll be in, you know, different places all around the country. So how primarily once this thing hit, all types of dates for cats was dropping off, you know, even...
Oh, that's it. You know, that's it. Once this hit, brother, everything canceled. Everything canceled. It's nothing.
Yeah.
Zero.
Okay. I know. I seen it. It's ugly. It was what it was. So one of the other things that I'm getting from Cass is, man, a lot of dudes are out here doing different things to try to keep money in. One of the blessings we got as working comics these days is that the internet can help feed you. You know, so do you have anything that you're doing? Like, are you selling any of your past performances online anywhere? Are you creating anything else?
That's a good question, man. Right now, what I'm doing is that I'm offering comedians, if they want to get their set better, if they want to get their set tighter, if they want to work on something, things. So what I'm doing, I'm offering, like, basically a online workshop.
Okay.
I tell comedians a 30-minute session, $25. We can FaceTime or talk, whatever's comfortable for you, and we'll go over your set, and I'll do the necessary tweaking or basically give you insight on how to make you an even better comedian.
Okay.
And if you want to do it for an hour, it's $50. And that's been working, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, praise the Most High. Been working because comedians been reaching out to me because all of them tell me they reached out to me that they respect what I do. They respect my work. And so they're willing to listen to what got me to where I am. So I'm appreciative of that.
That's awesome, man.
I need more. My fault, because I need to say this.
No, this your shit.
I need more comedians to hit me up because I'm still selling drugs, too. And I don't want to do that.
Hey, bro, it's legal in Chicago. Yes, sir. That's what's up. So how can people contact you for these consultation sessions, bro?
They can follow me on Instagram under Owens Ordeal, OwensOrdeal. Owens Ordeal is everything. Twitter, Owens Ordeal is on Facebook. The only difference is it's two words, yeah. Owens Ordeal. So everybody can hit me up. My full name is Lawrence Owens. And I always wear this because you know I'm a Redskins fan, but this does, so they know what picture to look for. That's why I'm wearing the hat. They're like, oh, dude with the Redskins shit on.
Yeah.
Dude with that sad ass hat on. Exactly.
Yeah, sad. But I can't say too much about you because our Chicago Bears, man, I wouldn't even know them motherfuckers if they was in the store with you. Nobody on the team. They like the Bulls. Them motherfuckers could be working at the Shopping Mart now because they ain't doing basketball. And that shit's finna get even crazier now. You see that horse game they tried to pull off? What? Horse? Man,
they tried.
Didn't nobody tune in to that.
Nobody.
Right. They had to tell you who was in the game on the news at night.
I would rather have that than to have over 400,000 people tune in and then you just lay a dud like Teddy Riley did.
Yeah, that was
not
that was embarrassing, man. You better be careful, man. Teddy Riley might kill himself. You know what I'm saying? This is not to be played with, bro. that was an embarrassing moment. He couldn't sell tickets with to nothing now, bro. Ugly. That shit is ugly, man. But back to business, bro. You know, because I don't want to take up a lot of your time, man. I appreciate that you would give it to me too. But I'm all about, helping my brothers and promoting this deal. So right now you're doing a consultation. And man, it would be a lot of dudes who would be lucky to be, to work with you on that. And they egos, a lot of cats' egos is in the way. They don't even be, they're not smart. Like back in, before I started, I was a DJ at All Jokes Aside. So I would watch these comics that are like D-Ray Davis, Deion Cole, Corey Holcomb, they would help each other. You know what I mean? They would tag, teach dudes tags, tell them this might work. Watch this, try this, walk this way, say this, move the mic, whatever they would do to help each other. And that didn't filter up into these days. It's, this hater, I'm on my own vibe has come. So what you're doing, man, is stellar. It's really, respecting the art and helping build it. So I really think that you should mention one more time how they could get your shit so they don't have to rewind. Just say it one more time.
Everybody follow me on Instagram under Owens Ordeal. OwensOrdeal. Owens Ordeal. Follow me. Hit me on the inbox. Say who you are. Leave your contact information. I'll hit you up for 30 minutes consultation. It's $25 for an hour. It's $50. And it all includes that. We're going to set.
That math, you're supposed to say for an hour is $40. You don't get the same half hour price for the two.
My fault.
You're supposed to say for, you raise your 30. I'm going to edit this out. You raise your 30, your $30 for the half hour. Then you say it's, for $50, you get an hour and 15 minutes. You know what I'm saying? So they take,
take two.
You upsell them.
Right. Yeah, go ahead. Take two.
There we go.
Follow me on Instagram, Owens Ordeal. Inbox me your information. I'll connect with you. You can do FaceTime as far as that. If you don't have an iPhone, we can do it through Instagram. And what it is that my consultation fees are for a half hour, 30 minutes, and for a full hour, hour and a half, depending on your schedule, because I ain't doing nothing, it's
$50. There you go. That's awesome, man. And you know what? Here's another thing. Do you have anything like a poster or a flyer that could be passed around for that? Because if you don't, I'll help you develop one. And then you can hit it up.
I don't.
It's going to be haters, man, to be honest with you. It's going to be dudes jumping up, talking about some, who is this nigga think he could do this and all that. But you're going to get people that's smart enough to know that it don't matter what it is, man, you can always learn something extra, especially in this game. You know what I'm saying? So I'm proud of you for doing that, because everybody that I've talked to, man, they, you know, of course, they selling their DVD online.
Right.
So then you got cats who's actually trying to do shows online. You know what I mean?
What happens when that dries up? Like when you sell all of your DVDs and you can't get another shipment in?
Talking about, you know, there's websites where you just upload your shit.
Oh, okay.
And they
pay for it
and download it. So you don't have physical. You don't have physical ones. And if you need some help setting that up, let me know. I got you on that. I'll show you how to get it done. That way you really don't have to carry around merchandise no more. Nowadays, cats got these little cards. They like scratch-off cards. And you sell the card for a certain amount. They scratch it off. They get a code. They either go to your website or go to your website.
I need that, Aaron. Tell me what you need from me, because I have an album online on Apple Music. It's called Astute Intuition. I have a comedy album that's already out. It's on Google Play, it's on Spotify, and it's on Apple Music called Astute Intuition. So yeah. I would love to be able to do that, and they scratch the code out and they can download it that way.
Well, those platforms are already international, so all you got to do is market that. And I'll tell you right now how to do it. You take either the cover of it that you've already created, and you put it on your Facebook, your page. And when it says boost this, you click the boost, go through the process, and you might have to pay $50, but you're going to get your money back. Because Facebook is pretty good at actually doing what they say they're going to do. I've sold tickets through Facebook. I have not tried to sell my DVD or CD, because mine is kind of old, and I haven't, it's just online. So once in a while, somebody will find it and buy it. But with yours, you do that, man. And, you know, you fuck around, wake up one day, you got $8,000 in your shit. You know what I'm saying? This dude that didn't add that. I'm not lying. Believe me. And if it's already on Apple and iTunes, those are easy platforms. You don't even need the extra shit. All you got to do is create a little card, put it online, and keep passing that shit around. And if people go, they buy it off iTunes, you might, you know, whatever. It's a lot of dudes doing that, man. Cats who I know that people might not enjoy their DVD as much as they'll enjoy yours.
I appreciate that.
So that's what's up. There's places where you could actually sit down like you're doing right now and upload a class. You got to write the class out, you know what I mean, what you're going to tell the people, but you can upload a class. I'm about to do that one. I did it, but my video didn't come out sharp.
Mm-hmm.
So then they told me I couldn't upload it, but I had the whole thing set up.
That's what's up.
You know, there's other avenues out here, man, that cats are starting to make money where they take their profession of being a creative mind, and then they make money. Like I know I interviewed one dude that he throughout the little library I'm gonna be uploading, and you'll see this dude just go online for some of those places where you can write an article for people, and you just write an article, you know what I mean, and they take the credit. So look for those, man. Look for that. And that way you got ways to make money while we sitting in the crib, while you writing your jokes and stuff or whatever.
Right.
As well as, you know, because we don't know. First of all, we don't know how long this virus thing going to be circulating throughout the United States.
True. They did it. You see, they did a test run in Florida, and now they said it's like over 1,400 cases just like that. So all that did was just push the needle back even further.
Yeah.
When they're going to let us out. So
yeah, and they dumb enough to fall for that shit, right? They guinea pigs. It was dumb. Florida ain't never really had a right education process right, man. I don't know what they was thinking. That's all they opened up the beaches.
Right.
Out there.
Right.
Ooh, golly.
You are absolutely right.
They couldn't have wrote it better.
Exactly. Here's the test run to let you know that, come on, man. You should have known that was a trap. But hey, it's what it is. But back to what you were saying earlier about the haters, let me tell you something, what I've learned about that. I've reconditioned my mind to think differently on that. Right now, Aaron, as we speak right now, I don't have any haters. Let me tell you why. I believe haters are people who go out of your way, out of their way to stop you or impede your progress, or can stop or impede your progress. You understand? Everybody else is just envious.
Yeah.
So everybody who has something to say, who will be like, who he think he is, he ain't funny. Those are envious people. They're not haters, but they're not going to stop me. You understand? I believe a true hater is someone who goes out their way to stop you, or takes their time to continuously go out their way. Like, it was a time I was about to do TV, and a comedian told an executive, don't put him on. That's hate.
Yeah.
That's hate. You understand? Yeah. But for somebody to say, oh, man, who you think he is trying to get classes? He ain't qualified. That's just envy. That I'm not worried about, because I'm still going to give the classes.
Yeah.
I'm still going to have people hit me up. I'm still going to have people say, help me. I'm still going to be funny. Can't nobody stop me, Aaron, unless the most I said my time is up. You done seen what I can do. Chicago done seen what I can do. And if you come out to my show, you going to see what I can do.
Right.
Can't nobody stop me until you hit that stop button and be like, time's up. You know what I'm saying? It's up to you while you hear anybody to recondition who you are to be able to play within the rules of whatever game you choose.
Right.
That's what it's all. That's what I had to learn. I had to learn the rules and the unwritten rules of how to move through this comedy game. You know what I'm saying? You got to be political whether you like it or not. And I used to rebel against that. Remember that?
Yeah.
I didn't want to be political. You understand? Right. I didn't want to understand the rules. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. You're going to learn either one way or another.
One way or another. You think you're going to get far because you're funny? Okay. So then back then, I did have haters. They was purposely stopping, but they was doing it to teach me a lesson on, you're going to learn how this works. Now, how creative you get through that and exploit loopholes like Bill Belichick. You understand? Like the loopholes he exploited, be it. As far as the overall aspect of it, nah, you just ain't going to funny your way through a door. It ain't happening.
Yeah. One of my favorite examples of that back in the day, people used to be like, man, all you got to do is go up there and be funny. I'm like, man.
Right.
If it was about being funny, I like to say, man, at the time, Marcus Combs was one of the hottest cats in Chicago. I was like, man, Marcus Combs would be a millionaire. He'd be a billionaire. But he's not, because it's funny. Yeah, if it was about just being pure funny, it ain't that. You know, like D-Ray Davis learned that early. He knew you ain't have to be the funniest dude ever. You had to be funny enough to make sure you got enough people that want to come see you. Then you got to know how to do that business end, and you got to know how to dodge them politics, man. The dude was an artist, man. He was a fucking phenomenon that if it's not written down or put in a movie, that it's lost. Because, you know, this is just my opinion, he doesn't have the personality for somebody else to love him enough to write his story yet.
Right.
But if he write his own story, or if his family or friends that love him write his story, it's one that Black folks need to learn. Just like that Dolemite movie, where they was showing you that, man, Dolemite, although his stuff was horrible and ignorant on the main thing, according to some people, he went out and, you know, set up theaters on his own, built the business on his own. And basically owned his masters, right?
Right.
In film and comedy. And I don't know what his pockets was like when he passed away, because Hollywood still tries to control that type of a person. They try to ostracize the people who are smart enough to create and hold their own art. But right now, his family, whoever's in charge of his estate, they making some paper, especially because Eddie Murphy put his stamp on that shit.
Right. And so before his time, he had bread in his pocket, because that's what it's all about. When you're able to, like you said, own your own masters, own your own content, That's where the money is.
Yeah.
That's where the money is. But let me tell you what I believe, and this is an unpopular opinion. The fact that he was on the blaxploitation side.
Yeah.
I think that the white people supremacy, powers to be, whatever name you feel like labor, they was like, all right, that's just going to be a fad. Let him be.
Yeah. You know,
so he never messed with him, even though he owned his own label.
Yeah.
But if you have the ability to dictate the narrative, if you can manipulate the ideology, a la Sam Cooke, oh, we getting your ass out of there.
Yeah.
We getting you out of there. You own Michael your Jackson. Own masters.
Michael Jackson.
Yep. There it is. Exactly. You own your own masters, and you have the ability to bring consciousness to black people. You understand? And then you can put the sway on them, you know what I'm saying? The white to have them be like, get measured. Oh no, he gotta go.
Well, he gotta go. I think if you here's another piece of that puzzle. I think that the overall fear is that you'll have a person who can do all of that on the black side and then make it make sense to the white side. That's right, the person they're getting rid of. Like Michael Jackson. You know, I, you know, I'm like Dave Chappelle. I don't believe he messed with them kids. I believe they put their politics on. They did some of that in them CIA dark room type tactics on them and ended up making him look like a pedophile. And then I also believe that because he didn't yield, he didn't just lay down. He started buying the masters of different companies and you know, he started building and building and making sure that they couldn't ruin them. They sent a spike to him. That's an old ass game, man. Heroin dealers used to do that to each other all the time. I got two homies that they uncles both, that one of their fathers, they was cousins, so each one of their fathers got killed because the opposition gave them a lot of heroin that was 100%, and they told them it was 70%. So they went on and OD'd. That's what happened to Michael Jackson. That doctor was just dumb. Somebody gave him a vial of that shit, and it was a little bit too pure. Michael Jackson never woke up. Now Sony can deal with the mama, and she don't know shit. The father, they fucked up, ostracized the father, and got him killed. I mean, well, he died. Because he was a vicious businessman, he wasn't taking no shorts. You know, now Sony didn't, from what I understand, Sony bought their damn catalog back, damn near.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? She want to stay in her house, you know.
Which was the plan from the beginning. You absolutely right. You are absolutely right. And I said that before, too, Aaron. That's one of the jokes that I say on stage. Like, if my spirit leads me there, well, I say you got to be careful as far as when you're trying to bring consciousness, because once people start to latch on to you, they'll find a way to manipulate the situation. Like, let's say if I was rising up or giving back or helping or people latching on through my comedy, right? And then I say, and once they catch on, they'll be like, oh, man, they put a bug out there. Well, the one y'all call Lawrence Owens, he had sex with a girl, a 16-year-old in 1992. So the first thing people gonna hear is sex with a 16-year-old, but not realizing in 92 I was 16.
Yeah, exactly. You understand what I'm saying?
People ain't gonna think so far. They're gonna say sex with it. So you can be like, I put the truth out there. Yeah, but you know how you did it. You know you danced around it and manipulated it. You understand what I'm saying? You presented it in a way. It's one of those situations. Remember how when you was little, you'd be like, pick a hand. But you put the hand out.
Right. You put the hand out there. That's really good. Man, I forgot about that joke.
Oh, he had sex with a 16-year-old in 92. I knew he was perverted. You know how people are. I knew he was a pedophile. But in 92, I was 16. Too late then.
Exactly.
Too late. We didn't already change our mind.
Right.
And you know how black folks are. They can't come together to stand for something, but they'll come together to be vicious on somebody.
Look how we just did Teddy Riley. Teddy Riley. That motherfucker just knew his career was finna come back. He was like, I'm back home. Me and Babyface finna do it. me and Babyface finna, man, we finna rumps in the bump. You know what I mean?
And then the y'all whole Chicago accent came on, like, what this nigga on? You know how y'all
Yeah. Joe, what's up? What's up, Joe?
Man, what's up? What's up, Joe? What that nigga on?
Yeah.
He on
shit.
Shit.
Yeah. So yeah, we got that issue, man. But it's all good, man. So I guess, man, we after this COVID thing, because this is our primary focus, so we don't, you know, get too off on people. We put a good title on there. So what, you know, besides the continuing to build that hour that you were gonna do, man, what you trying to do? Are you gonna move to LA? Are you trying to do New York? I know you were in Atlanta for a minute. You still in Atlanta right now? You in?
No. I'm back in DC. So here's word of advice to people who want to do anything as far as entertainment. It don't have to be comedy, but anything as far as where you need the people to help you ascertain a platform. Whatever you're going through in your personal life, take care of it right then and there.
Yeah.
Because it's going to come a time where you're going to be on the precipice of a level that you worked hard for. But if you never corrected that personal issue, just like anything, it's going to fester. It's going to grow legs. It's going to get bigger. So now that's what's going to impede you. But you got to be strong enough to not use that as an excuse, because that's what people will do. Man, he did this. She did. No, you should have fixed that. You knew how your career was going. You knew you was getting buzz. You knew you was moving up. Should have rectified that situation. You understand what I'm saying?
Yep.
So once I rectify that situation, then it's back on. I can go wherever I want, Atlanta, LA, or New York, wherever I choose. So that's what I'm doing now, you know, as far as that. So when I get that squared away, Brother Foster, then I'll be like that five-star recruit. Where I'm going to go? L.A., Atlanta, or New York.
Right.
And quiet as kept, you can go to Chicago and get busy too now. You know, I love Chicago.
Don't
get
it twisted.
A person can move to Chicago and get busy. People don't ever underestimate Chicago. You can go out there and make some things pop now. I love Chicago. Sure.
We like to say most of the main heavy hitters are from Chicago. You know what I mean? That's how we like to ring it. You know, I mean, Kevin Hart
that's
is from
arrogance.
Yeah, that Kevin Hart is from Philly.
That's all arrogance. DC he got up the there. Nicest comedians. DC, Brother Foster.
All right, y'all got that little Dave Chappelle dude. You know what I mean? That's who y'all got, man. That's it. Tony Woods, you know what I'm saying? Other than that, y'all shelf started. Y'all on like top shelf and then bottom shelf. You know what I'm saying?
What you on, Joe?
I just talking shit. It's all funny. Good, man. Yeah, yeah. Now y'all got a good solid, you know, Dave Chappelle, man, killing the game right now. I love what he's doing. You know, the dude has got it to where we really want it to be. You know, we don't want to be up there. Everybody got to be dancing before the music come on. And you get up there, you got to be yelling at the people and doing all this. And, you know, we don't want to be there. We want to get on stage. And
also, Chappelle taught us that, again, owning your own masters, meaning your life.
Yeah, exactly.
They was willing to give him. Let me tell you something, man. Remember Chris Rock had a joke that he said, whoever, like he said, Shaq is rich, but whoever signs Shaq checks is wealthy. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so if they, no matter how much amount of money and white people able to give you that pie is just so much bigger than you can find. They was ready to give this man $50 with ease, like it's nothing.
$50 million
is what I meant. Yeah.
Yeah.
But damn, $50. I'm talking about my session, the 101. Anyway. but he was smart enough to know, look what comes with it. When you believe in yourself and not afraid to bet on yourself, when you know who you are, nah, y'all keep that.
There's
too many stipulations and pitfalls to come with it.
You
basically want my soul. And that's why I'ma always say that's the man. That's my guy right there. Whether people think you're funny or not, I don't care. Right there, he lets you know. Your soul should not be for sale. You're going to get on the back end.
Right.
As soon as you're like, oh, he fell off. He just didn't ever. Netflix gave him what? $80 million for four specials or $60 million? However many. He's straight now.
And he crushed the motherfuckers, boy.
Crushed them.
crushed him. He, you know, I mean, that motherfucker brought that book Pimp on the that other one. I was like, wow, he, you know, he really dropped it on them, man. He put some science on some of them they never understood. They still ain't figuring it out. I'm like, boy,
that's my point. Now he can be him. That's what I'm trying to get. It's not about the money or fame. This is me. I ain't speaking for nobody but me. I used to want to be famous, or you understand, or used to want that torch burnt. I don't want that anymore, because when I saw the what it paid to get in there, like, that's a pay-to-play field. You want to be on Kevin Hart level and all the people, you got to pay to play. You got to find out the rules for that and pay for that. I want to be able to have clout. I want to be able to grab a microphone and start talking like Chappelle. If that brings me a certain amount of money, so be it. If it don't, so be it. That's true artistry. That's right. What I'm working on every single day.
That's
you know what I'm saying? I don't like grabbing a mic and having to explain, don't be sensitive, y'all. Don't. No, man. I want to come out and just start talking. That's what I'm reaching for. Yeah. That's every day. I'm reaching. And I'm going to get there.
I don't think you're far from it if you're not already there and just not seeing it, man. Because, you know, I done seen you tame some rooms and I was like, this shit is a zoo. This shit is ridiculous. These motherfuckers, they did not come out to do nothing but this. You know what I'm saying? So, you just got to figure out how to get the paper behind it. You
that's
know?
It. That's it.
Corey Holcomb is actually conquering that in a masterful way. Although, I'm not sure if he intellectually can handle it, because sometimes he slip off into what I consider, you know, not some goofy shit. You know, it's like generally about beating up women or hating on, you know, I guess I won't say hating on women because I define it of it, but his shit is anti-woman a lot, but the other parts of it is masterful, man. Like he openly says, man, I'm creating a platform that I'm in control of. 5150, he can go anywhere right now.
He can go anywhere.
Besides the fact that he's an incredible comedian,
right?
Period. The people know how to get in contact with him, how to watch where he gonna be and what he doing. And that's Hollywood. That's exactly what Hollywood is. He just own his own masterful piece of that, you know, which
that's what
I think
it's about.
We all should do.
That's what it's about. Owning your own masters, Brother Foster. That's gonna be my new motto for my life. And master is, like I said, symbolic of whatever your situation is. I'm gonna start owning my own masters, man, because I'm going to get there, because I'm enjoying the process. And anybody who listens to this, they always enjoy the process, but never fall in love with the process.
That
was an issue for me coming up. I was falling in love with the process, and that makes you comfortable. And once you're comfortable, then your fire dissipates to the fact that somebody can come and go and blow it out. I had to learn all these things, man. You gotta have that unlimited fire at the beginning of the Olympics. Right. You know, when they light that fire, that joint be on for the whole 3 months that the games is going on. You understand what I'm saying? Yeah. I mean, but of course, I don't mean literally 3 months, but it has to continue to go on. You have to find a way to challenge yourself to keep that fire going. And the fact is, I love challenging myself and what comes with it. All the foolishness that comes with this game, the backbiting, the lying, I'm with that shit. I'm not saying I do it. I'm with it, because it weeds out who's weak and who wants it.
Right.
If you get mad because this game is backstabbing, nigga, go sell burgers. Go do something else. You understand what I'm saying?
Right.
You, all this that we go through is testing you to see how nice are you. That's like in football, man. When you drop back the pass and the team keep blitzing, what you going to say? Stop blitzing so we can run our play. Really?
Yeah.
You make adjustments.
Right.
Keep your tight end in. Keep your running back in. Right, receivers run shorter routes. That's what I love, with the ability to do that. You understand what I'm saying? Who you are. Because if you're able to maintain all of that and find a way to work through all that and still be funny, that's where the respect comes in. And that's where people respect you. And I'm just going by what you said earlier. Like you said, you saw me in a couple of rooms that were zoos. And I was able to get them under control, like, yeah, what? Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
And I was, after we got them under control, Aaron, I was still able to bring the funny.
Yeah.
That's where people, absolutely, the respect comes from, where your constituents, your peers, and the audience be like, I fuck with him. That's how you build your fan base. You understand that's what I'm saying?
Yes, sir. That's what we're doing, man. And you know what? Oh, I think that's the perfect way to end this, man.
My man.
That's it, bro. Hey, I thank you for your time, man. And we're going to get, you know, we're going to do some business again real soon.
Looking forward to it, brother Father. Call me if you need me, man. I love you to pieces. You my guy.
Yes, sir.
Shout out to Marcus Combs and Corey Holcomb, these people.
Oh, Ballhead, man. He just got out the hospital with that COVID, too, man.
So I love Ballhead, too, man. Shout out to Ballhead. Yes, he is, man. So, shout out to them comedians, because I love them all that you mentioned. They're all great comedians, man.
Yeah.
And I love you, man. Hit me when you need me, man. All right, boys and girls.
All right, man. Later.
My man.